I remember last November when Cardi came out of nowhere and started playing snippets on IG Live with red hair and a new style, posting pictures of him and Ye, tweeting all this cryptic shit, and that's when we knew something big was about to happen. After years of delaying and capping about Whole Lotta Red, the long wait for his next album seemed to be finally over. And that's when the album was confirmed to be dropping on Christmas Day. And, you know, we were really excited to get new music, cause as Cardi fans, we're used to starving. Then, on Christmas Day 2020, Whole Lotta Red was finally released. We no longer had to rely on dog shit leaks that sounded like they were recorded on a fucking Atari 2600. But there was a slight issue. This wasn't the Whole Lotta Red we thought it would be. Even though, I don't know what y'all expected, I mean, you could tell by the new snippets that he stopped using the baby voice, and you know, that he's on his punk vamp shit now. So anyway, people were not happy. They went from saying that he's Santa to saying that he's the Grinch. Like, it's crazy how he went from being the most praised and loved person. Like, people was treating him like he's the second coming of Jesus, to then being the most hated in the span of a few minutes. Many were not fucking with it at all. They took it to Twitter and YouTube comment sections to complain. A lot of them were doing the most, saying that Playboi Carti fell off, and that Whole Lotta Red is the worst album ever made. And you know, to top it all off, the Whole Lotta Red merch dropped with the album. And, let's just say it wasn't the best. I mean, I've seen a lot of trash merch, but this was some next level shit. While looking through all the merch on the website, I honestly forgot that I was even on Cardi's site. I genuinely started thinking that I was on the wrong website, that I accidentally clicked on the site of some satanic black metal band. Bro, just look at this. This is some real satanic shit. I also remember this double cup candle. Like, bro was really selling some wild shit. Now, you know, when I first heard the album, I enjoyed it quite a bit. I thought a lot of the songs were, you know, pretty good. But even then, it took time for this new sound to grow on me, and, you know, on a lot of others too. And looking back on Whole Lotta Red a year later, it's kind of crazy to me how many went from despising the album to saying that it's easily his best work, or even saying that it's one of the best albums ever made. Not only that, but it's already so influential. Now, you know, I know he didn't start Rage or Plug and B, but he made the Rage sound so popular. Like, literally everyone's been hopping on Rage beats. I honestly feel like Cardi's development isn't talked about enough. Like how he went from dropping his, you know, Chief Keef type shit in 2015, to the self-titled era, to the drugged out psychedelic dilit era, to the Whole Lotta Red leaks, baby voice era, to the fetus voice Atme and Pay 1993 era, to the Whole Lotta Red vampire punk era, to now, you know, I guess the narcissist era. You know, now that I think about it, wasn't this guy supposed to drop Whole Lotta Red Deluxe?
I was the one on the block with my pole. I hit a Glock 19 before I was 19 years old. I was only 11 when I saw my daddy scrape the bowl. Now he facing the 10, free my pops, free my folks.